Welcome to Women of Style, where we feature women who effortlessly exude confidence, class, and inspiration. And we love it when we have a smart, self-assured woman who knows what works, whether it be in her ensemble she chooses that day or life in general. I am psyched because today we have an incredible woman on the show. Now, back in the day, she was dubbed as one of Manila's OG It Girls, known for her gorgeous face, her style, and lineage. But this woman is way more than that. An amazing mother, a successful entrepreneur, philanthropist, and now a bag designer based in Italy. Today, we have the luxury to get to know Mai Mai Cojuangco. And we have her, we have Mai Mai Cojuangco on the show. Hey, you is woke today, girl. She is currently jet lagging. When did you fly in?
I flew in last Thursday.
Oh my goodness, it's a few days ago.
4 days.
Usually jet lag, what, maybe 2-3 days to get over?
Yeah, but then at night when I go to sleep, I'm thinking of a million things.
Like?
Work, what's my schedule, stuff I have to do, stuff I will do, stuff I did.
And this is all when you're home here in the Philippines, like you're just running like what you can do before you fly out.
Yes. Oh, it's super hectic.
And how many times do you fly back to our hood?
3 times a year, 3 to 4 times a year.
And then this is a mixture of seeing your family and your business, so it's two.
Yes. I think that's guilt-free traveling, right? Yeah. And you can put work and family together.
Yes. So. And this is the home that Mai Mai Cojuangco grew
decorated
up in.
By my mom.
Yes.
As you can see, her passion for Philippine culture and, to be precise, Mindanao. I was born here. I grew up here. But from a very young age, my mom used to bring us to Mindanao, which has always been her love, her passion, and the source of exploration. I mean, we went to Cotabato, we went to Holo, Basilan, Tawi-Tawi, all those places.
Do you get to go there sometimes during your 3 times?
No, unfortunately no. I would like to at some point to work with the artisans there, but I never have time, you know.
When you do come here, so you are bombarded with needing a mixture of work, trying to fit in the family. And then, but at least this is like your safe ground though, here in your home.
So it's always nice to come home to your friends. And of course, family, that goes without saying. And I love that I'm able to incorporate work now. And then it's always being torn by, you know, having your daughter leaving her because she has school. Mm. And then I get here and then everything is packed. And I love being busy, actually. I'm always like, do.
So you can't sit still, really. You have to always have something happening.
I am an introvert, and I'm also a creative person. So I need those moments where I'm sitting still, because those are the moments where I get stuff done. My brain gives birth. I vomit designs.
My visuals, my
lines and
birth
stuff.
Of a new bag.
So
throwing up visuals.
You can't do those things, right? When you're amidst, you know, having dinner or whatever. There's a creative process that happens, and you do that most of the time in solitude.
Did any of your work regimen come from any of your parents? Did any of them, like, were you guided by maybe one or the other or both?
Both of them never had like a 9-to-6 working structure, but they've always been goal-oriented and both have always been busy. And I think it's also character, right? Because, I mean, at the end of the day, it works much better for me to work from home, because that allows me the flexibility to still be a mother and work around the hours of my daughter. But I love to work. I'm a workaholic. You know, if I'm not doing something, I feel guilty.
I'm worried what happens to you when you're not working, Mai.
No,
what happens
when
if you're not giving
working.
Birth from your brain or like throwing out visuals? What happens to Mai Mai Cojuangco when she's still?
I'm on Netflix. I'm watching DIYs with my daughter. So it's like pure daughter time.
A talented designer and a doting mother at the same time, Mai gushes about her biggest inspiration, her daughter, Demi.
I love the fact that I have a daughter. Because I, first of all, I said, of course, when I got pregnant, and I was like, God, I really wish I have a daughter. Because I have four sisters. Mm. What am I going to do with a boy? Whatever I have will go to her. Mm-hmm. And she's at the stage now where she's trying on my shoes. Mm. She's like, Mama, I really like these shoes. Can I have them? Yeah, one day you can wear them.
Mai may seem to be pulling off these roles effortlessly, but going after her dreams was not as easy as it seems.
Work, family, home, it's Europe, it's Philippines. I need to understand the European connection, and I hear that you are based in Italy.
Yes, yes. I've been living there for...
Wow, that long, Mai.
Yeah. 18, 16, I went to a school that actually changed my life. It's a state-sponsored school in Florence. And I learned how to make bags there, like with my hands. I'm like, my God, these are powerful hands now. So I was taught how to make a bag from the pattern, which begins with paper, obviously, until the physical bag itself. And it was like a total immersion with bag making. So after that, I worked. And I worked as a designer, as a graphic artist, and as a bag maker.
It's been a while.
Yeah, my daughter's turning 9. And so it's work and motherhood that I'm always trying to
juggle.
That's why I'm lucky to be able to work from home.
And so, now you are bringing this internationally.
Yes, I decided to begin here. I partnered with this store, this lady who owns the store. It's called Ide. That's basically how it began. So I just began last year. Like I've always said, I love that quote. I don't even know where it came from, but I saw it once and I said, that's it, that's me. And it's create the things you wish existed. So when I do things, I always say, okay, how does this work? How can this work and how can it make my life better? And I apply that to everything I do and everything I create, even with the bags that I've made. So
I love that, Mai. Create what you wish existed.
Yes, always.
I love learning so much about Mai Mai Cojuangco and her passions and tuning into her rhythm. When we come back, we'll listen to more about Mai Mai's life and love and her bag line when we return.